Hey, IT pros, Lem here again. Are you down with downtime? I'm not. Although it's not ideal, it's a reality. So let's address it. Tim, thanks for joining us today to talk about downtime. Can you tell our IT pros a little bit about yourself?
Well, I'm the solution architect for Hewlett-Packard Enterprise Small, Medium, and Business Solutions. Spent 20 years in the military, learned a lot of technology there, and then after the military, it was a natural shift into IT, where I was a sysadmin for several years, and now I'm working here at Hewlett-Packard Enterprise as a solution architect.
So you actually worked in the small business, and then you moved on to helping small businesses.
Yes, that's correct.
So as far as downtime, what kind of solutions does your position provide to mitigate those?
So in SMB, it's a struggle, right? Because you have to balance how much things cost with what capabilities you have. And of course, small businesses, small and medium businesses don't have the resources that bigger companies have to invest in their IT environment.
Right.
So they have to balance. They have to figure out what priorities that need to be addressed and figure out what is the most important to them. And then consider that from the top down. So they start by looking at, what are some areas that are potential single points of failures, for instance. Sometimes downtime is not avoidable, but you can have good downtime where you take time to take your network down or take parts of your network down in order to do those kinds of maintenance things that help keep it running.
We look at small businesses and the ultimate plan is to grow. So we have to plan for growth all the time.
Absolutely.
So what are some tips that you could give to help us understand the approach to kind of growth and mitigating some of these single point of failures?
Sure. So actually it starts when you're first building your network that you want to plan for growth. Mm-hmm. So you can't wait till you're growing to start planning.
Right.
A lot of that has to do with things that don't even involve technology. It involves how you manage your IP addresses, for instance, on your network or things like that that are not necessarily specific to a piece of hardware. But as far as the hardware goes, having hardware that can be expanded helps.
Right. So, Tim, what are some key reasons why our environment will experience downtime?
Well, there's hardware failure. So those things are easily mitigated by making sure you have some redundancy in your systems. But then the more difficult one would be things like cyber attacks. So cyber attacks are very prominent. They're prevalent today. And you can defend against them, but they're much harder to defend against because that's an unknown, right? And so getting some extra help in that regard will definitely go a long way towards protecting you and making sure your systems are updated. So spending that quality time with your downtime plan, your planned downtime, then you can help keep your system from being a target for cyber attack.
Right. What are some good ideas for preventing single points of failure?
Well, single point of failure is, if you have just one thing and it goes down, then you're down. So,
right.
So having duplicate things like that, so for instance, duplicate switches, duplicate servers, those kinds of things can help prevent a single point of failure. Within each of those pieces of equipment, there's actually usually some redundancy built in, such as many, many items in the IT environment.
Right.
Will have redundant power supplies. They'll have redundant disk drives for being able to, recover. If one disk drive dies, another one's keep going so it keeps the server running while you replace that disk drive. Many of them are actually hot swappable.
So if you were to leave us with something today to help us mitigate any future downtime, what would that tip be?
Well, the first thing would be, if you have the luxury and you're starting off from the ground up, then planning ahead for growth is the biggest thing. Making sure that you don't paint yourself into a corner, so to speak, with limited hardware. Secondly, the biggest thing that you can do is plan periodic maintenance. So if you do that by keeping up your security patches, keeping up your firmware updates, those things will help prevent you from being attacked, for instance, from a hack. That will help prevent downtime, right?
Right.
So planning ahead for maintenance. And then I guess finally really is when you are able to, you need to expand into thinking about redundant systems so that you have one system take over when the other system fails.
Well, you heard it from the expert. Big thanks to Tim for stopping by today. Now, Tim, go take your downtime.
Yes, sir.